Good morning, students. Today we are going to see the construction. In that construction of a tangent to a circle to a given point. So in this construction, there are different types. In that first type is construction of a tangent to a circle when its center is known. Okay. So if you will see this example, draw a circle of a radius is 4 cm with center is O. Draw a diameter POQ through the point P or Q. Draw a tangent to a circle. So from point P or from point Q we have to draw a tangent. Okay. So now first we will draw the required circle with radius 4 cm which is given. So we will take a 4 cm distance in your compass. This is center O. Okay, radius is 4 cm. Draw a diameter POQ, which from point O we have to draw a diameter. So this is your diameter POQ. So this P, O, Q is your diameter, right? Now we have to draw the tangent to the circle with center O, either point from the point P or point Q. We have to draw a tangent to your given circle, okay? So I am going to draw from the point Q, okay? So take any convenient distance in your compass and as the center is Q, draw a semicircular R. Okay, then without changing the distance to mark of 60 degrees. Okay, then here this relation between the radius and tangent we have learned, that is 90 degree angle. So we have to consider here 90 degree angle. So bisect this to R. So you will get 90 degree angle. This is your required tangent when circle of center is given. You will give your name T. T dash. Okay. So T, Q, T dash is your required tangent. T, Q, T dash is required. Now this is the construction when construction of a tangent to a circle when its center is given. Okay, now we will see the next type of construction of a tangent to a circle when its center is not given. Okay. Now we will see the second type construction of a tangent to a circle at a point given point when center is not known. We have here center is not known. Actually, we have to construct, we have to draw a circle, right? With the center. Without center, we cannot, right? So with the center, but without help of the center, we have to draw the, or we have to make the construction of tangent to the given circle. Okay, so here first example, draw a circle of radius 4 cm. Take a point P on it, means we have to take. See here, draw a sketch, you will see here. Here this circle, okay, we don't have to use the center of the circle. Then take a point P on it. Here you have to take any point, suppose this P, okay. Without using the center of the circle, draw a tangent to a circle at a point P. Means from point P, we have to draw a tangent to a circle, okay. So this tangent we have to draw, suppose the tangent be like this, means this segment passes through this point K. This is the tangent. Okay. Then how we construct the tangent to the circle without using this center of circle. Now, what we have to do for this purpose, from the point P draw one chord to this circle. So this, suppose P is the one of the chord, right? Then take one another one more point on this remaining part of your circle. So suppose this point is R. Next step will be there to join these O, R, P and R, Q. Okay. Now this is your tangent. So what is the relation between this, this angle Q, P will give here, then this T and this is T dash. So angle Q, P, T is always equals to angle P, R, Q. And when it is possible, or when it is like this angle P, R, Q is equals to angle Q, P, T, then it is possible this T dash, P, T or P, P, T dash, which is the tangent of the given circle, where without using the center of circle and from the point P, when the point P is given on the circle. Okay, so actual construction we have to do this. We have to construct angle Q, P, T is exactly equals to angle P, R, Q. Okay, so we will now see the construction. First, we have to construct a circle with the given radius 4 cm. Okay. So here, take distance of 4 cm in your compass. Okay. Draw a circle of here at point P, one of the angle at point P which is exactly equals to PRQ. Okay, so supposed to be QP, T angle measured, right? So first, take any convenient distance in your compass. Put one end of your compass on R. Then draw this arc. Okay, similarly without changing the distance, keep one end of your compass on point P, right? So, make an arc. From point P, understood? Then, what we have done here? Take a minimum distance in your compass, put one end of your compass on R point, draw an arc with this. Similarly, the same procedure without changing the distance, keep one end of your compass on point P and to draw an arc. Okay, now next step will be here, adjust the distance between these two points. Okay, so we have to adjust the distance between these two points, right? Now from point, from here, point of intersection of this pod and this arc, here we have to keep one end of your compass and we have to draw another arc which cuts the previous arc. Okay, so this. Now this point of intersection of this arc and this point we have to draw. Right?
Then, actual calculation means how this BP
you got how much measurement that you have to show, right? So here first consider pen, draw a circle with radius 4 cm. So take 4 cm distance in your compass with 4 cm radius. So now join this. This point is A and this point is B. Right? Now from point B you have to consult the tangent. So for that purpose, so this is the O to A, 4 cm distance, and O to B is 6 cm distance. Okay, so we have to draw the perpendicular bisector, means we are actually have to select the midpoint of this OB. Okay, so how to select the midpoint of OB? So we have to draw the perpendicular bisector of OB. So adjacent to more than half distance of OB, right? Then make an arc from point B. Then from point O. Join this. Thank you. got the two new points, this and this point, on a circle of radius OA 4 cm, correct? On this point only we have to point out, we have to find the new points that makes the tangent with this point BP and BP. Understood? So the point of intersection of this circle on our inside circle is the circle with radius 4 cm. This we will give the name P and this point Q. Understood? Now join this BP and BQ. Okay. Now BP and BQ are required tangent. Okay, BP and BQ are required tangent. Here BP equals to BQ. Correct, because tangent from the external points are equal. Now here they ask also verify the measurement by actual calculations. We have to find what is the measurement of BP. So to find the measurement of BP, we have to join this OP. It is okay for this upside, means this okay, because this side become same. So now if we have learned one theorem last year. Now this is the circle with the center C, and this is here diameter. Okay, OB is the, or BO is the diameter. So center with C and OB is a diameter, and one more point on this circle, that is the P. So here P, so if you join this, then angle in the semicircle is always 90 degrees. So if we have to find, if we have to measure the BP, then we take this angle in triangle BPO. Angle BPO is a 90 degree, because if you will take this dotted line circle, okay, then BO is the diameter and BP and this OP join here at point P. So this is the angle BPO, is the angle in the semicircle. So measurement of angle BPO is what? 90 degree. So we can use the Pythagoras theorem. Okay, so in angle BPO, by Pythagoras theorem, what? BO square equals to BP square plus PO square. Okay, BO square equals to BP square plus OP square. BP square plus OP square. Actually, we have to find BP square. Okay, so BP square equals to BO square minus OP square. So what is the BO? BO is total 6 cm. So 6 cm square minus OP. OP is the radius, that is the how many cm of this circle? 4 cm. So minus 4 cm. So 6 square, 36 minus 60 equals to, you will get 20. So BP square equals to 20. So we want BP only. So BP equals to under the root sign 20. So square root of 20 is approximately 4.47. So BP equals to, you will get 4.5 cm. This is the actual measurement. Okay. Now we will see next example. The next example, draw a pair of tangent to a circle of radius 5 cm which are inclined to each other at an angle of 60 degrees. Okay, so here this is circle, correct, of center O with radius 5 cm. Okay, so we have to construct the pair of tangent to this circle. So pair of tangent is tangent from this point and this point. So this is the pair of tangent. Okay, inclined angle 60 degree. Or inclined to each other an angle of 60 degree. So here 60 degree angle is there, right? So of course when you use English we have to consider this pair of tangent which inclines each other at angle 60 degree. So of course if we join this radius to this and this, okay, center this A, this B and so on to this T. So here this is 90 degree angle between the radius and tangent is always 90 degree. So this 90, 180, this 180 plus this 60 degree 0, then 40, 240, right? And this remaining angle is 360 minus 240 equals to 120 degree, right? So here this construction we can do by two methods. So first method we will see how to construct this exactly 60 degree angle and these two tangents are equal. Okay, so pair of tangents we have to draw which imply the angle 60 degree. So first we have to draw a circle of radius 5 cm. Okay, so take 5 cm distance in your compass. Radius 5 cm. First we will select the center here. This center is O. Okay. We will see here the two steps, two methods of construction. You can do by any method. So first method here, draw a circle of radius 5 cm. Don't change the distance. Now here take it down to this center is O. Okay, so here OA. OA is how many centimeters? 5 cm. Now take A as a center and OA is the radius. Take A as a, for that you have taken O as a center and OA equals to 5 cm radius and we have drawn the one circle. Now similarly the without changing this with the same 5 cm radius and A as a center. So we have to construct another one triangle which passes through this center of circle. Okay, so from point A we have to consider another one circle which passes through this point O. Now this point of intersection of this we'll write B and this is supposed to be C. Okay. And we'll join this. So here we have taken this A and B, so here we write C, no problem, O, C and here B, means P, A and B. So this point is A. Now this is your from point P. This is your required triangle which incline an angle of 60 degree. But how it is 60 degree that we have to verify, means we have to justify this construction. Okay. So for the justification, now see how this angle is 60 degrees. PA and PA and PB are inclined at angle 60 degrees. We have to show this angle APB is 60 degrees. How it is possible? Now see, if we join these OB, right? So OC equals to OB, correct? So OC is 5 cm, so OB is also, this OB is also 5 cm. Okay, now here what we have taken? Here, after constructing a circle with center O and OC is the radius 5 cm, right? Similarly, the same distance or same radius and C is the center of your circle, we have construct OC. Or CA equals to CP. From point C we have construct the another circle, correct? So here if we will join this CB, then CB is also equals to how many centimeter? Of course this is 5 cm, right? If you see very properly, then see this CP is also how many centimeter? 5 cm, correct? CP and CB, CP equals to CB, these both are the radius of the circle of the center C. Similarly, OC and OB are the radius of the circle with center O, correct? Now what OC equals to CP. So these all are equals to each other. So in now we will see the triangle BCO here. BC equals to CO equals to BO. These all are equals to each other. So of course these angles are how many degree? 60 degrees. Actually when all sides are equal, so this triangle is which type of triangle? Equilateral triangle. So in right, just for the justification, in triangle BCO, CB equals to CO equals to BO equals to 5 cm. So triangle BCO is an equilateral.
So this is 120 degree angle, exactly this is
standard, isosceles standard, and if we use the same property here, then it is straight, correct? So this is the tangent and this is the radius of the circle. OB or OB is the perpendicular to PB. So this whole will be 90 degree. Tangent between angle between the tangent and radius is 90 degree. So if it is inside angle for this 60 degree, so how much remaining? This is 30 degree. Okay. So of course this will be 30 degree. So two methods you can say here, this angle and this angle is 30 degree because of CB equals to CB equilateral isosceles triangle, and hence this angle and this angle is 30 degree. This 180 total is 180 degree. And if this is the angle BBC is 30 degree, then this also 30 degree. Because like this, if you join here on this part, okay, and if you take this, then PB equals to PC, okay. So here you will get this also 30 degree. So this 30 and 30 degree equals to 60 degree. Understood? So in this way, these two equal tangent glad at angle 60 degree. Now we see the second method, how to conserve the same construction. Okay, so first we have to draw a circle with the, what is the radius is given? Radius given 5 cm. Okay, so with 5 cm radius we have to construct the circle. So draw a circle. This is center. It is compulsory to write down when you make the construction. You have to write steps of construction and justification. So here this center is O. As we have seen here the rough figure, center is O. This O A and B, and this is the external point B in right angle 60 degree. So this is the 90 degree. This 90 degree, and this, if you take this quadrilateral OAPB, then quadrilateral measurement is how many degree? 360. So remaining angle is 120. Okay. Then that is interesting. Because the center of this. So we have seen the rough figures. This OA and OB are perpendicular to PA and PB, so this 90 degree angle, this 60 degree, so remaining will be here 120 because sum of all angles of quadrilateral is 360. Now we will do the construction here to join OA, take A point, so OA here, radius, okay, 5 cm. Now we have to construct the tangent from point A. So how we have seen the construction, first construction from point on a circle we have to draw the tangent. So how? So take the mean distance in your compass to make an arc. Now next step to make the semicircular, cut off the semicircular arc without changing the distance. Okay, now we have to construct the perpendicular, we have to construct 90 degree angle. So from point this and from point this, then join this point A and this, so you will get tangent which passes through point A on the circle. So you can extend this. Next, Here at the center, we have to construct 120 degree angle. So how to construct? Take any convenient distance in the compass. Take O as a center and draw an arc. Okay, we want the at point O, we want 120 degree angle, correct? So draw arc without changing the distance. Keep point of your compass on point this. Make an arc of this is the 60 degree and this is of 120 degree. Okay. Then next step, join this point and this is the 120 arc. So we get this another radius. We can extend also this, no problem. Okay, now this is the point B. Now from point B we have to construct the same tangent to the circle. So whatever we have done here, same procedure we will do. Take convenient distance in your compass. Keep one end of the compass on point B. Draw the same circle. Okay, don't take from the outside, from the inside. Make the arc which cut off the previous arc. Okay, now here perpendicular is 90 degree. We want, so draw 90 degree angle at point B. So you can change the distance, no problem. From this arc, make one arc, and from this arc, make one arc which mirrors in this arc. Okay. Now join this point B and this point of intersection. So you will get at point B 90 degree angle. So here you will get how many degree angle? 60 degree angle, because this is of 90 degree angle between the tangent and radius. This is of 90 degree angle between tangent and radius. Here we have a 120 degree angle. So 90 tangent is 120. So it will be 60 degree. This is your required angle that tangent inclined to each other. Okay, now we will see next example. So you can use here taking of the curve method. Okay. Okay, next example, let ABCD a right triangle in which AB equals to 3 cm, BC 4 cm and angle B equals to 90 degree. BD is the perpendicular from point B on AC. The circle through the point BCD is drawn. Construct a tangent from the point A to the circle. Okay. So here, this is your right angle triangle ABC. Okay, ABC. So we have to construct tangent to the circle from point A. Means here, triangle is there, that circle is there, the circle passes to the point BCD. Okay, so one more point is there, BD point is there, and here, BD is the perpendicular from the point B or AC. From B, we have to draw a perpendicular from this AC. Suppose this is D. Okay, so here this circle passes through the BCD and also from here A, from this A point we have to construct tangent to the given circle. Then ABC is a right angle triangle. So first we have to construct right angle triangle. Now BC, here AB equals to 3 cm. So first draw AB with the 3 cm. is AB equals to 3 cm. From the point B, we have to construct 90 degree angle. So we will do the construction of 90 degree. So take convenient distance in your compass and at the center B, draw semicircular arc. Without changing the distance, to make arc of 60 degree, then bisect these two arcs, you will create a 90 degree angle. Join this point B and this point of intersection of these two. So you will get 90 degree angle. Okay. Then BC equals to 4 cm. We have to take BC equals to 4 cm. Take any distance, make arc. Here, okay. Then take more than half distance from these two arcs. Then join this. So from this point, from the point B, you will get here perpendicular. For this, BD is a perpendicular. Okay. BD is a perpendicular to AC. Then BC. BC is a diameter. Take BC as a diameter and draw a circle which passes through the point B and point C. It means that first you have to find what is the midpoint of BC, right? So find out the midpoint of BC. So for that purpose also we have to find the perpendicular bisector of BC. So take more than half distance of BC, make an arc of this from point B, similarly from point C. Okay, BC is the diameter of the circle. We have to construct a circle. Okay, so for this purpose, we have to find the midpoint of BC. So midpoint of BC. So how to find the midpoint of BC? Take more than half distance of BC and from the point B and C make the mark on this opposite side. So you will get this midpoint, it is O. Now OC equals to OB. OC equals to OB. circle will pass through from the point. Okay. What did we say? After constructing a right angle triangle at point B, we have to construct or we have to draw the BD perpendicular to AC. So how will you construct the BD perpendicular to AC? From point B, we have to select one distance. From that distance, we have to make the arc. From the point B, one end of your compass, if point of B, make this arc 1 and this 2 arc. Then afterwards, adjust the distance in these two arcs and make a more than half distance. So, you will find the perpendicular bisector of this, build point of these two. Between these two points, you will get exactly equal points. You have to find the midpoint of these two points. Okay. So for this purpose, we have to make more than half distance and draw this arc on both sides. One here, two, and from this point, this one marks and this two marks. Okay. So point of intersection of these here. Point of intersection of these. We have to join it. Okay, so you will get this BD is BD. This ray or this, after joining this, where this intersect AC, that point of intersection is your B. So BD perpendicular, BD is a perpendicular to AC, right? Next step is take BC is a diameter. It means that radius is the diameter. Radius is half of the diameter. So for that purpose, we have to find the midpoint of BC. So how will you find the midpoint of BC? Adjust the BC distance in your compass. Okay, take more than half distance of BC. Marks on both sides of here. BC on left and right, similarly from point C, left and right. Then join these midpoints with the scale. You have to join these midpoints with the scale. Sorry, you have to join these arcs with the scale. And wherever this intersect, this BC at point, that is the point is your O. Now, this way you got the circle whose diameter is BC, that center you got as a O. Now adjust OC and OB distance in your compass and O as a center, draw a circle which passes through the C, B and from point D. Understood? Now next step is there.
Okay. amount of OA. Now, afterwards, you have to adjust OA this you have to adjust. Give your name. So we need the name O dash. Okay. So adjust O dash O and O dash A and draw a circle which passes through the point O and A. Also, it passes to the point B. Okay, now what we have done here? Next step is take OA as the diameter, it means that we have to find the radius. So, midpoint we have to find the midpoint of OA. So, for that purpose, adjust the distance of OA more than half in your compass from point A, make the arc on upside and downside, means both the sides opposite to point A. Similarly, from point O, you have to make another arc which intersects the previous arc. Okay. Afterwards, join this arc with the scale only. Don't draw the line. Only to join this arc with the scale. And here, after if suppose we draw the line, so what is the intersection of this point? So point of here. That is your O dash. Okay? O dash. Then adjust the O dash. Now this is the midpoint of your AO. This is your midpoint of AO. What is O dash? Afterwards O dash O and O dash A adjust the distance in your compass and O dash is your center of circle. Draw a circle which passes through the O and B. Also, this circle will pass through from also the B. Okay. So now you got here another one circle which passes through the point O, B, and here A. Okay. Now here this circle intersects your previous circle whose center is O. So this point. Okay. So you write here this D. And point of intersection is at point B. Correct? So this next one circle whose center is O dash which passes through the point A and O which intersect the previous circle whose center is O and radius are OB and OC at point T and at point B. Now in this way you got your required tangent which passes through the point A to the circle with center O. Okay, so join this O, join this A T. Okay, so this A T and this A B are your required tangent. Okay, so A T and AB are required tangents. Okay, so in this way we will draw the given construction. Now, next we will see the constructions of a tangent to the circle from external point when center of circle is not known. Here we know that the center of circle. Now we do the construction of the tangent from the external point when center of circle is not given or not known. Okay. Now we will see the construction of a tangent to the circle from external point when center of circle is not known. Okay. So for this example, draw a circle of radius 4 cm. Take a point P outside the circle. Without using the center of the circle, draw two tangents to the circle from the point P. Okay. So here circle with radius how many? 4 cm. Then point P is outside the circle. Suppose this point P is outside here.
So by without using the center of circle, we have to construct the two tangent to the circle. Means from here we have to construct two tangents. So simple construction is this only. Draw tangent to the external point of the circle, but without using the center of circle. Now first we have to construct a circle with 4 cm radius. Draw a circle with 4 cm radius.
Point D. So this is the point of intersection.
and D.
Okay, next is
PD is the radius of your circle. Take PD is your radius of circle. Okay, we have to adjust the PD distance to your compass. So PD is the radius of circle and draw the arc which intersect or which cut off this your original circle. Okay, so only we have to make the marking. So PD is the radius of circle and draw the semicircular arc like this from this side. Okay, so here this point and this point. Okay, so no need to draw this exact line, only take the PD as a distance and make the mark which intersect your original circle at the two different points. These points you will take as this T, and this is the point of intersection with this T dash. Now in this way we got here, so from the point external point P that we have taken, so from the external point P T and P to T dash.
Construction. Thank you.